Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Aja Major Ayodele Fulonjo. I'm the head of surgical department in the Republic of Sierra Leone Armed Forces. I have it all. It's in me, the true me, the world's best kept secret. This is me. I've been in the military for the past 40 years, and being a Muslim woman in the military, it is not easy. You have those that are completely, totally against you. And at times you find it difficult to do your job as a Muslim woman. One thing I believe is my hijab does not make any difference with what I do with my job. It's been so much going on, but I still try to keep for my faith because I'm doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not easy going to work and coming back every day to keep my 5 daily prayers and to wear my hijab. I would like to send out a message that our hijab does not limit our capacity. Our hijab does not limit our brain. Our hijab does not limit whatever the other people can do without their hijab. And for me, my hijab is my job. It is quite a battle to use your hijab, not only in the military, but all the forces. I'm trying to plead to the government. I'm trying to plead to Mr. President. It is part of our constitutional right. We are not going to fight for it, but we're asking, please, if we can enjoy our constitutional rights by wearing our hijabs to various workplaces, including the forces. There are times when you don't feel good about just being half naked. There are times when we have nurses coming to work, they have to use the back of the building, take off their hijab, their abaya, then they put on their uniform. And then when they're ready to go home, they have to take off their uniform, put on their hijab and put on their abaya. Even if they wear something very, very little, like a cap on their head, they said it's not allowed. Please, I'm appealing to the people responsible. I'm appealing to the government of Sierra Leone to help us wear our hijab in our workplaces, in school, and in different areas. We need to show who we are. We are Muslims. We want to practice our Islam. We want to make sure others respect us for what we are. We are not doing it to please anybody. Like I said earlier, we're doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I believe it is our constitutional right. That's the most important thing. It is our constitutional right to cover up. And please don't take that away from us. And one thing I'm against that I hope you brothers can help me talk to this young girl is these tight-fitting clothes, these tight-fitting gloves with their hijab. We do not have fashion hijab. There is nothing like fashion hijab. Hijab is hijab. You dress modestly. And let me tell you something. I'm above 60. You know 60 or what? I've done 40 years in the military. And I was in my 20s. But I can bet anybody that I look good. I know I look good. Yes. Allah knows I look good. So it's serious. Yeah. I know I look good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows I look good. And Allah knows I'm doing this for Allah. Oh Allah, you know I'm not doing this for show. I'm doing this because it is what I should do. It comes from you. You gave it to my prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is in the Quran and we have to cover up. Please, you young ones, don't fashion this hijab. There is nothing like a fashion hijab. You dress properly. If you know your clothes is thin, wear something underneath. This skin tight does not work with see-through dresses. It looks like you're naked because you hear the word skin tight. So I'm appealing to you all. At times I feel like crying. Honestly, I really feel like crying because they're disgracing us as Muslims in this country. And it is our constitutional right. It is our constitutional right. I cannot repeat it again. It is our constitutional right. You all go out there and tell your sisters, tell your friends, go to the market, go to the masjid, go to the schools, go anywhere in the workplace. People can reject you. They've rejected the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So who are we for people not to reject us? But I know with my hijab, I look better than a lot of people. Because Allah knows it's my hijab and look good. So you for you to tell me not to dress the way I'm dressing. You will never find me. Even at home, I'm so used to this, I don't even take off my hijab at home. I forget I go to bed with my hijab. Because after I do my last prayer, after Isha, I will sit there and do other prayers. When I go to bed, I just relax because I'm so used to it. I live 4 stories up. Nobody walking on the street will see me. But because I fear Allah, I don't want to be out in that veranda without my hijab. Because I fear Allah, and this is what I want to instill to you, the young ones. You have to do it for the fear of Allah, not the fashion. We cannot be wearing those tight fish in there. It is hijab is not fashion, it's not a fashion. Hijab is to protect us. Hijab, we respect. Allah, we live for. Please, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you the young ones, don't joke with your hijab. Hijab is not meant only for old ladies. When I tell people my age, nobody believes my age. I've been doing this, and I know everywhere I go, I look good. I look good in my uniform, I look good without my uniform. I'm just going to appeal to Mr. President and the entire cabinet in Sierra Leone to please, for God's sake, don't take our hijab from us. Don't take our Islam from us. And don't take our respect from us. With that, I say, Masala.